Welcome to episode 3 of our Greek Isles vlog with Seabourn. Please subscribe to our channel and select the bell to receive notifications of our new content. Thank you. Today, a sea day was spent largely at the gym, spa, and retreat. Okay, that's enough time at the gym. We had purchased a spa day pass, which at time of recording was US$25. My favorite part of any cruise ship spa are heated stone loungers like these. The retreat, along with all public areas of the ship, are covered in full detail in our Ovation ship tour video. The retreat is a pay-for use area, which at time of recording was US$249 for a sea day, $149 for a port day, or $100 a day average when purchased for the length of a 14-night voyage. As there were many places around the ship to relax, and this was a very port-intensive itinerary, we found that just one day here was enough for us. Food and drinks are available throughout your stay, including an extensive menu for lunch, all of which are included in your cabana fee. The whirlpool is quite nice, though you may not find it necessary when it's 30 degrees Celsius outside. Still, cool, tasty beverages brought to you make it even nicer. As wonderful as the retreat experience is, we left our cabana a few hours early to catch a surprise presentation. On board this week just happened to be Robin West, the head of expeditions for Seabourn.
Milestone, we of course have had the coin ceremony, we've had the Madrina ceremony, and it's been a fantastic journey. And actually a journey that started about 4 years ago, is when we actually as a company started talking about an expedition ship. We were also very cautious and very particular that we did not want to create a different brand. It has to be a Seabourn brand, but we are of course creating quite a different product in terms of where the ship will go, how it will explore these remote destinations, and what the onboard experience will ultimately be. So Seabourn Venture, the first ship, will launch in 2022. The yet-to-be-named sister ship will launch in 2023. Each vessel will have 132 suites, accommodate a maximum of 264 guests. We will have about 233 crew on board. We have a PCI-strengthened hull. So what does that really mean? Basically, what that means is the vessel is capable of operating in ice up to conditions or thickness of ice up to 1.2 meters or 4 feet thick.
I listened to a wonderful singer while waiting for Holly to join me for dinner.
We've seen you in all familiar places, that the sound of mine embraces all day through. In that small cafe, the park across the way, the children's carousel, the chestnut trees, the wishing well. Every lovely summer's day, everything that's light and gray, I'll always think of you that way.
Thank you very much.
When the morning sun and when the night is new, I'll be looking at the moon, but I'll be seeing you.
While this specialty restaurant is included in your fare, reservations are required.
Watching the ships roll in, and I watch it roll away again.
Steak at the Grill by Thomas Keller is simply the best at sea. It is fantastic.
I can do
the next morning, we had breakfast at the colonnade while approaching Cyprus. After breakfast, we went for a coffee at Seabourn Square. Amra has been fantastic. Here, we decided together to name this coffee bean roaster James, as he resembled a friend of Thomas the Tank Engine. Our tour today was the Agios Neophytos Monastery and organic brunch at Sofia's Traditional House. Neophytos was a monk and a bit of a hermit whose writings preserved a history of the early Crusades. In 1159, he came to this area where he found a cave and excavated it to include a hermitage cell, a small chapel, and even his own tomb. If you're familiar with our vlogs, you know I'll almost always stop to care for an animal. In addition to the cave, be sure not to miss the rest of this complex, which contains a church and a museum. Our guide explained some of the area plants as we approached our final stop, a lunch at an organic farm, where a very charming family have turned their home into a business of making traditional goat's milk cheese of Cyprus, halloumi. Sofia was very kind and made really good cheese and bread.
She's using salt. Ναι, τούτο που κάνεις όμως πώς το κάνουμε.
Πώς το έκαμε. Βάλουμε το γάλα, βάλουμε ένα μπωματάκι πιτιά ή λεμόνι, κουταλάκι λεμόνι, πίτσι. Βάλουμε το μέσα σε τα τεταράκια.
Half one spoon lemon. Λεμόνι πες μου.
Ναι, βάλε και λεμόνι.
Λεμόνι. And it's boiled. Τώρα θρύθουμε την πιτιά.
The milk boils and makes a curd.
Yes, yes, and becomes, and it got to this shape. She puts them nep. I'm going to forget to tell them. Παρακαλώ.
Μετά βάζουμε το.
But it's not very salted. She used salt, but it's not very salted.
Thank you. We had a great day out and look forward to our sail away party and dinner with a friend. A few hours after the sail away, we returned to Earth and Ocean for dinner for a very special evening. 4 months earlier, I reached out to the Seabourn president to help me surprise my partner for our anniversary with our first Seabourn cruise she didn't know I had booked. I was put in touch with Handré, who graciously agreed, along with many of our friends, to be part of a Zoom call to spring the surprise. The classified operation went very well. It was time for me to be surprised a few months later when, 2 days into our cruise, I answered our suite door to be greeted by Handré, who was on board for meetings. I had no idea he was here, and it was just a wonderful surprise. He is a very gracious person. We got to spend a few hours with him for dinner this evening and throughout the rest of the week. Just a perfect thing for Seabourn to do for us. We hope you've enjoyed this episode. Please consider subscribing and clicking the thumbs up. Have a look at this video's item description for links to Handré's music and YouTube channel. In our next episode, we visit Rhodes and Santorini. Thank you for watching.